Everyone, let's continue lesson 7, solving equations. Open your book, page 21. Here we have a word problem. Take care of the word problem, because I have each word has a meaning, okay? Here it's telling me the length of the playground. Length, it means L, okay? Is 3. So L is 3. 3 meters shorter than 3 times the width. Let's see this one. It's a complicated one. So don't write L equals 3 only. No, look here. It's telling me that the length, L, is 3 meters shorter than 3 times. 3 times means 3W. 3 times the width, this part is means 3W. And shorter than means you're going to make minus. So minus 3. Okay? So here I have what? Again, 3 meters shorter than means I'm going to make minus 3 from the 3 times the width. Okay? The perimeter is, so this is what? This is the length. This is the length. Okay. He's telling me the perimeter is 210. Do you remember the rule of the perimeter? The rule of the perimeter? Perimeter of rectangle. Perimeter of rectangle equal 2 times length plus width. 2 times length plus width. Very good. My length is 3W minus 3 and my width is W. So how can I write it? It will be 2 and bracket 3W minus 3, which is the length, plus 2W equal to 120. Then I'm going to solve this equation. How to solve it? You're going to make times the 2 times inside the bracket. Here, 2 times 3, it will be 6. Okay? 2 times 3, it will be 6W minus 3 times 2 is another 6. Okay, let's see it here. So it will be what? Again, it will be 6W minus 6 and plus the 2W. Let's take what? Take the W. 6W is the 2W. 6W and 2W are 8W. Minus 6 equal to 108. 210. Okay? Time. What I'm going to do here? We said in the session that we're going to do what? We're going to finish the plus and minus first. We're going to finish what? The plus and the minus first. So what I'm going to finish here? I'm going to finish the minus. I have here 6 minus. 6 minus 6. I'm going to take it to the other side with plus. 210 plus 6. 210 plus 6 will give you 216. So 8W equal to 116, then what I'm going to do with the 8? What I'm going to do with the 8? I'm going to, 8W means 8 times W. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this 8 to the other side with divide. With what? With divide. If you divide 216, divide 8, it will give you 27. It will give you 27. So I have here the width. The width is 27. I'm going to take this 27, okay, and substitute here in this equation. Let's see what I'm going to do. I'm going to write 3, the L equals. 3 what? 3W, which is 27. 3, 27, or times 27, minus 3. 3 times 27 minus 3. It will give me what? 78. It will give me 78. Here. Will give me 78. Okay. And that's it. If he need anything else, I can give him. Because I have already the length and the width. If you want the area. Yeah. Do you remember the area? An area over rectangle equal length times width. Okay? Okay, let's take the other exercise. Okay. Here. I have here a triangle. Look here, triangle. We took in the geometry, in the session, in the lesson of the triangle, that all interior angles in the triangle equal what? Remember? 180 degrees. But here, I don't know the x. I don't know the x. So I'm going to substitute, to sum all the x's. To sum all the x's. So here, x, okay, plus what? 2x. Plus what? What is the third angle? 2x plus 5. I'm going to make the plus, okay? It will give me what here? It will give me 5x plus 5, okay? 5x plus 5 equal 180. What I'm going to do with the plus 5? We'll go to the other side with minus. Very good. So I'm going to minus 5 from 180, it will be 175. Very good. Now, if 175, what I'm going to do with this 5 beside the x? Any number beside the x means times. So it will go to the other side with divide. So it will be 75 divide 5. Very good. 175 divided 5 will give me what? The 35. So now I have the x. I can get any measure of any angle. So this one is what? This one is 35 because it's x. And this what? 2 times 35. 2 times 35 is 70. Okay? And you can get angle C. Thank you very much. See you next session. See you later. Thank you.